Hi folks, Bishop Michael here. One of the questions I'm often asked is, what do our benevolence offerings actually do? What do we actually get from those offerings? And what I always say is, what those offerings do and what you get is an opportunity to extend the reach of your ministry and to deepen your experience of discipleship. And today we're going to learn something about the extended ministry and deepened discipleship that we experience through our offerings to the Evangelical Lutheran Church in Canada. Those gifts represent fully 25% of the benevolence offerings that you and I provide. And I'm thrilled that our National Bishop Susan Johnson is here to share something of how those gifts are put to use. Hi, Bishop Susan. It's so good to see you.
Hi, Bishop Mike. It's good to see you too.
What can you tell us about how our ministry is extended through the work of the Evangelical Lutheran Church in Canada?
I'd be happy to do that. But first of all, I want to thank you for the generosity that the Eastern Synod has shown. In 2011, your synod contributed 38% towards the overall benevolence that was received by the National Church, but by 2021, you had increased that to almost 49%. Remarkable generosity, and we really thank you. Your generosity helps us live out our work in four areas of work: focus, courageous innovation, reconciled relationships, one body working together, and empowered disciples. But maybe I can just best summarize by saying there's three different kinds of areas of work that we do. We coordinate shared work and resources across the synods and across the church. So, for example, for the last 2 years, we've offered the summer sermon series where bishops and assistants from the synods and the National Church have contributed sermons, but the National Church has collected, edited, and distributed those to congregations. National Treasurer and the Synod Treasurers have worked together to help congregations navigate the financial realities around COVID and have begun sharing best practices that really help all of our congregational treasurers as we move forward. And of course, we've got joint national gatherings that we do on behalf of the whole church, like Clay, the youth gathering, and the National Worship Conference that we both do with the Anglican Church of Canada. Those are things that we can do as a national church that are bigger than what any individual synod could do. We also do a lot of work in advocacy at the national level. So we joined with other ecumenical leaders this last year in expressing our support for Bill C-15. With the Anglican partners, we wrote to the Minister of Foreign Affairs expressing our deep concern about the escalation of violence in Gaza as part of our ongoing concern for peace in the Holy Land. And through our partner with Canadian Lutheran World Relief, we promoted two special appeals, one of which was to assist with the COVID-19 crisis in India. And then secondly, to help with the recent and tragic earthquake in Haiti. We also work in partnerships, our full communion partnership with the Anglicans, but it was the negotiations between our two national churches that provided that opportunity. We then went on and established full communion with our partners in the United States. And now we're considering full communion with the Moravian Church as expressed in Canada. We also are in partnership with organizations in Canada like Kairos, the Ecumenical Justice Initiatives, and with the Canadian Council of Churches. And internationally, we partner with the Lutheran World Federation and the World Council of Churches. And they do things that we can't do as a national church, but help us benefit from. For example, the commemoration of the 500th anniversary of the Reformation. What we were able to do here in Canada was a result of what the LWF was able to do. And with the World Council of Churches, who are the ones who originate the Thursdays of Black campaign, working to end gender-based violence. As we look into the future, there are some things we really want to emphasize doing. Of course, we're going to continue to speak on major issues that come up in the life of our nation. We are going to continue our partnership with our global mission partners in Peru, Argentina, and in the ELCJHL, knowing that the ELCJHL is also your partner. But one of the big new directions of work were in four task forces that began at the last convention. A task force on addressing racism, white supremacy, and racial injustice, a task force on addressing ableism, a task force on addressing homophobia, biphobia, and transphobia, and a task force on achieving carbon neutrality in our church. These are things that we can do better working together as a national church and then resourcing synods and congregations. So, in conclusion, thank you for your generosity, your faithfulness, and your partnership. Thank you for supporting the wider church through your generous giving, and thank you for your ongoing prayers and support. You guys are wonderful partners to the National Church.
Thank you so very much, Bishop Susan, for what you and all your colleagues, partners in the National Church do to extend our experience of discipleship. Thank you so much. God bless you.
You're so welcome. God bless you.